Hi, everybody. This is Christopher with AG Productions once again. Wanted to do a video real fast about the eBay auctions for this week. I know we're running a little bit behind. Tonight's video is going to get put up tomorrow morning. Last night's videos got put up this evening, so we'll catch up eventually. But for right now, let's just deal with these auction things. I already did this video once and ran about 12 minutes long, so I'm going to try and hurry it up this time. First on the chopping block, Lizardman Saurus, old school box. This is the kind of box I was telling you guys about for those of you that are new to the Warhammer world or the 40K world. In the mid to late 90s / early 2000s, minis came in boxes like this. You got eight figures in a box and it was only $12.50. Not a bad price at all. In this box, you get seven Saurus Warriors that look like this. There's enough shields for everybody. The only guy, the only one that there's a problem with is this guy right here. This guy has no head and no right arm. But other than that, the other six guys are perfectly fine. They come with the 25 mil bases. You also get inside this box three skinks. It appears to be that these guys are a command group. You've got some kind of like a totem or icon bearer. You have what appears to be a champion, and then a guy who's obviously a musician because he's carrying a drum. These guys are all metal, and they do come with 20 mil bases. So, that is all inside the Lizardman Saurus box. Next up on the list is, let's see here, this guy. Durthu the Tree Man, okay? This is a very cool miniature. It's an old-school Wood Elves model. It apparently has been primed at one point, but I can't see any indication that it's ever actually been assembled. To give you an idea of how big this model is, I'll attach the face to the back of the mini. All right, and then I'll pick a foot. Let me grab this one here, I guess, and I'll just kind of insert that there. All right, and then his right arm is the largest arm. Let's see here. There's the connection. Okay. From the base of his foot up to the tip of his right arm is about 2.5 Space Marines tall. Okay, so if that gives you any idea of how big this model is. Pretty substantial model. Out of print. Really cool. But it came in a lot that I bought off eBay. In fact, most of this stuff did. And I only wanted one or two of the figures from the lot, so the rest of the stuff gets to be put back up on eBay. But yeah, really cool figure. Would make a really nice, like, dryad or something like that for a Wood Elves army. Or do they even make Tree Men anymore? I can't remember if they do or not, but if they do, this would make just a really good generic Tree Man. You could probably even use him as maybe some kind of a lord or hero for your army. Or if you just wanted a cool display model. There you go. So Durthu the Tree Man is up. We have a new set of Lizardmen, the Saurus Champion and Musician. All right. Really cool old-school style models. Musician with a drum. Saurus Champion there. I'm not really sure what kind of weapon he's got. Let me see here if I can tell real quick. There it is. Over there in the corner. It's one of those, kind of like Egyptian / Aztec style knives. Very cool, though. Again, all metal miniature. Having a repeat, since these didn't sell last time, of the Saurus Warriors with spears. Okay. Again, really cool metal. Lizardmen Saurus models. The Bretonian Knights of the Realm with the panther head on his crest there. Okay, let's see. We have Setra the Imperishable from the Tomb Kings set. Sometimes, actually, according to the box, his official name is Setra, Lord of Khemri. When they released him, it was Setra the Imperishable. So, names change over time, but the figure stayed exactly the same. I like this model a lot. Unfortunately, my Tomb Kings army is just never going to happen. And so there you go. You guys, this model, the box has been open, but nothing has ever been cleaned or assembled or anything. Even the horses are still on the sprue. But yeah, there you go. It's basically a brand new model. All I did was open the box. Let's see here. Let me close that up. And we also have a gosh, throwing stuff. A Lizardman Slan Mage Priest, or Slan Mage Priest, not really sure how to say it. This guy has been primed and somewhat painted, apparently. Not very well. Doesn't appear that it's ever actually been assembled, though. I can't tell any areas where there's been glue marks, but most of the miniature has been painted what appears to be goblin green, and that's about it. Maybe a coat of, that's probably ultramarine blue or something on a few areas, and then definitely some blood red on a couple of areas, but that can easily be stripped off with some pine salt. But really nice. Temple guard carrying a Lizardman's Slan Mage Priest on a palanquin. Very cool. By the way, if anybody from GW is watching, go back to using these foam inserts for your metallic miniatures. Don't use those plastic things anymore. These foam inserts, A, they work better, and B, you can use them to make like city fight terrain by converting them into ruined buildings, and they look awesome. So, yeah, switch back to this. It's very cool. Anyway, that's up on the block. This is a complete model. I checked it out. Every piece is in there. Again, just another portion of a large lot of stuff I bought off eBay. Let's see here. I also have, if I can get that box closed, Lizardmen Army Book. I'm not sure which edition this is. I think it's 5th edition. It could be 6th edition, though. I'm not that familiar with the Warhammer stuff. I'm pretty sure it's not 4th edition. It looks a little too colorful to be the 4th edition, or anything further back than that. So I think it's 5th edition. If anybody knows for sure, leave a comment down below, and I'll put an annotation like on top of this thing to say yes, it's 5th edition, or yes, it's 6th edition, or whatever it is. But really cool army book if you're interested in learning some of the old school fluff. Got a lot of really nice, well painted models and things from the days when Games Workshop focused a lot on painting and not so much on gaming. Really cool dioramas and things. Just a really, really nice book. But that's going to be up for sale as well. And then we also have, just like as always on eBay, all of our Let's Paint DVDs. Now, again, if you have not seen the preview video for these, go check them out. They're on, if you go to our main channel page, just scroll down right under the right under the featured video, there's a section called Playlists, and just load up the one that says How to Paint Videos, just play them all. Again, if you're not familiar, we have Lucius Panderwagon, Eldar Warlock, Doc Killingsworth, Black Templars, White Scars, and then the brand new baby is the newly refurbished and redesigned cover with the Imperial Fists. So, all that is going to be up for sale this week, so hope you guys enjoyed it. God bless you, and I will see you in the next video. And hopefully, Lord willing, the next video I will be uploading will be the Signar Warcaster. The Eldar Swooping Hawks I'm putting on hold for right now. Part of the reason is I remembered why I didn't paint them in the first place. And the reason I didn't paint them is because I have a very difficult time painting Eldar. I don't know what it is about them. But unless it's like a warlock or one of like the aspect warriors, like the, well, not all the aspect warriors, the swooping hawks, for some reason I have difficulty painting. But we'll get around to it eventually. And yes, so there we go. Also, I've got a, another, once we finish the Signar Warcaster, I'm going to let you guys decide. There's two figures I've got that I need to get painted by September for a contest, or for two different contests, actually. And so you guys are going to pick which one is next. One is a for a game called Void. It's a pretty nifty set of miniatures manufactured by Urban Mammoth. It used to be manufactured by a company called I-Cor, but unfortunately they are defunct and no longer in business. And then the other one is for a company known as Taban Miniatures. They used to be Eastern Front Fantasy, but again, Eastern Front no longer in business, but Taban has bought the rights to all their figures. So anyway, all this stuff up for eBay. Next video, Lord willing, coming up is going to be the Signar Warcaster. So God bless you guys. Have a great rest of the evening, and I will see you next time.